obviously both teams have a strong bench tonight, having left plenty of players out of their starting lineups. But it's a chance for those players who haven't really featured too much to impress the coach. Early touch for Rabadanov. Ball bouncing through. Gloydman, who came off the bench in the quarter-final to drop in at centre-back, has started there tonight alongside Tolstopatiov. Ball in towards Chagla. Chris Makin's joining me for this one.
Chance to catch my breath there, Matt. Just run up from the studios there. Just interviewing Felix Sanchez, the Qatar manager. Very interesting comments.
Yeah, nice to get the thoughts, isn't it? Sort of a couple of weeks on from that Asia Cup win. Had time to reflect and
unbelievable,
just look back on what was a fantastic tournament in Abu Dhabi.
Yeah, and especially his thoughts on Aspire Academy in this tournament as well, which he took part in as well back in 2014.
Alta Nordu, very much a youth-based club, so it's their aim to try and have a whole team full of homegrown players by the start of next season.
Very interesting that, isn't it? Hopefully they can achieve it. Obviously win games as they go along as well.
Vlad Shitov. Samov.
Not really involved in high-scoring games, Alta Nordu. Won the first game against the 12-1-0, then a 1-1 draw with Bayern, and not beaten the last game, obviously, by Aspire, by Goldson Hill. So don't concede many, don't score many either.
Well, the man who has scored two goals, they'll be pleased to get him back tonight, wearing the captain's armband, Ennis Destan.
Well, obviously, when you look at his... his build is certainly going to be an aerial threat. Whether they can get forward and get the crosses in, that's another matter.
Celtic's ball crossfield. Doyeran, the man that was sent off in the final group game, so couldn't feature in the quarter-final.
We started well, haven't they? They've pushed Spartak Moscow back. Keeping possession, going from side to side, trying to get forward in this little passage of play here.
Yeah, they'll feel they have the short end of the stick, won't they, Alta Nordu, because they played their final group game and then they had to play the quarter-final the day after, which was not ideal. No, having lost Doyeran sent off as well.
Yeah, it was a bit of a killer, wasn't it?
Levchenko. Nice little give and go with Zakartsev. To Yildiz, substitute goalkeeper in today as well. First time we've seen him. It's been a mere kept goal in the previous three matches. Duyol with the throw. Good running here from Destan. We've still got possession. Suguchak, Destan. Too many white shirts between him and goal. Suguchak will try and win it back, though. That's good defending. Zakartsev, Shitov.
Yeah, the team's come over here, Mark. You know, they want to get as much experience of playing against different teams. But if here we go, there's a shot coming in. Not a bad effort.
Oh, good save. Yeah. Boryskin had to get a hand on that.
If I'm correct, if they lose this game, Alta Nordu, do they play Etoile in the next game? He played in the first game, so that'll be probably a disappointing aspect. So they'll need to make sure that they get a win.
Well, they've started in promising fashion. Boryskin taking no chances with that angle shot. A great chance. It was over Destan, but Tagia forward, volleys it over the top.
Oh, he's got to score. Oh, he's got to score. He's 2 yards out. fabulous chance for Altinordu. Mind you, Spartak win and they could play, they play Real Madrid, which would be a repeat of their first game.
That's right. Free kick to Spartak, foul on Rabedanov. By Tol Stopiatov. Tagia, man who had that chance a moment or so ago. Guni. Destan. Very good player on the ball, Destan. Out to Doyeran. Tried to thread it down that line. Davidov, the captain, was there with the interception. Now a chance. Uzun. Sakuchak, oh, poor touch, gives the ball away. Won back by Dyrjol.
Tricky conditions today, wasn't it, Matt? Especially in the first game, some wonderful football play, considering a really strong wind over on this pitch. Always seems to be a strong wind on this pitch.
And it's just a little bit more open, as we've said a couple of times.
Real Madrid were very, very dominant, weren't they? Type of performance we've come to expect from Real Madrid. That's better.
3-0.
Yeah.
Good ball plucked out the air by Yildiz.
Good run by Destan. He stayed on side as well. Just needs a little bit of support.
Through the legs of Gloydman. Oh, he's done well, Destan. Free kick. Yeah. Fouled on Samov.
Tell by the direction of the ball. He wins the ball cleanly there.
That's not foul. Can't tackle these days.
No. It's getting that way, isn't it? Rapidly.
Good article in the daily newspaper we get today on Altinordu and their philosophy and their coaching and their,
yeah,
their whole vocational school, as they prefer to call it, rather than academy.
Yeah. You said it right from the day one, what entails being a young player at Altinordu and their academy, and it's quite a fresh outlook, isn't it?
Yeah.
A bit different to everybody else's. I think they definitely took, I mean, they haven't done it on purpose, but they took the route of Crewe Alexander, where, you know, they're going to, like you said, they're going to try and produce a team full of young players.
Yeah.
Hopefully, the idea will be to get promoted into the big league. Hopefully, along the way, they might be able to keep the club going by selling these players. Mm. And that's a route they've decided to take.
Well, the interesting part was their owner, who is into steel, that's his business, bought the club for $10 million US dollars, and he ploughs $2 million of his own money into the club every year to keep the academy going.
Wow.
Which is a pretty nice situation to be in, but you just wonder,
how long is he going to do that for?
Exactly.
And then, you know, you do have to produce the players then, don't they?
But then again, if you could sell one or two players a year...
Yeah, exactly. You know, Southampton did it.
Yeah.
They had that period where they were selling to Liverpool all the time.
Celtic, Destan in on goal, it's a great chance, Destan! Good save again by Boryskin. Well, Destan's the danger man, you can see how much they missed him in the quarter-final. And Boryskin now has been forced into a couple of saves, Tagir fight over as well. It's been a really positive start from Altinordu.
Yeah, he just burst through there, Destan, he's got the armband on tonight, he's leading the way, showed great pace, gets his shots off, and that's a wonderful save for Boryskin.
It's a great header, wasn't it, as well, in that Etoile game to seal the points with 3 minutes to go.
Yeah, the goalkeeper came out and sold himself, but Destan kept his eye on the ball, nodding into an empty net. There he is again, nodding it back. Going to get a shot on target here.
Celtic.
Good tackle.
Good tackle by Safulin. But really congested in midfield. Still the ball's not clear. Sagucak, Celtic. Safulin once again. Now, Rabadanov, Levchenkov. Vladshitov. Dyrjol was just leaning into him and manages to eventually Altinordu win the ball back.
Can't get going, can they, this opening 10 minutes? Spartak Moscow is an attacking force, anyhow. Destan again. He's a handful tonight, isn't he?
Veskovic Vyacheslav, the Spartak coach. Obviously, side played yesterday, beaten by AS Roma, who probably just edging in as my tip at the moment to win this tournament. Rangers' firepower, though, of course, could leave them a serious contenders. Be interesting to see how Kashiwa Race will cope with them tomorrow.
Difficult one to call, isn't it? Rangers with a standout performance and result from the quarter-final stage. AS Roma with a fantastic win over Spartak Moscow, playing here now. Kashiwa Reysol did a number on Real Madrid. You can't discount Kashiwa Reysol.
We were talking earlier on about the difference when they play Real Madrid. Real Madrid, who line those five or four or five players up in a line from the corners.
Oh, yeah.
Kashiwa Reysol were quite happy just to sit in the six-yard box and wait for them to move, whereas in the earlier game, Etoile were just getting in amongst them and causing all sorts of problems. That's another good shot from distance from Vitali Shitov, comfortably saved by Yildiz.
I think you're always going to expect that physical aspect coming from the North African countries, whether it be Algeria, Tunisia or Morocco. They all, you know, they're very, very physical players, aren't they? So he was always going to get involved in that unusual lineup from Real Madrid. And like I say, Kashiwa Reysol just come up with something totally different. Here we go. Here's
good
a chance.
Again, it's Destan once again. Takes a touch.
Yeah.
And finds the bottom corner. And he has quality wearing the captain's armband tonight. Altinord. Oh, it's offside.
Oh, no.
Flag's gone up for offside.
Why did he let it go on so long?
Well, once again, it's another late flag. Or was it offside? Let's have a look.
Why are they waiting for him to score? He's onside.
He's onside.
There's another wonderful goal being chalked off. Well, surely this goes to VAR.
Yeah, the VAR should be looking and saying that's not offside.
That's a goal. It's got to be awarded a goal. And that's a quick look. You don't need many looks at this.
No, there she's going to the screen. It's
Thank
the goal.
You. Yeah.
Right decision. Destan has the opening goal. Altinordu have scored three. Destan has scored three. And VAR that denied Shenturk what we thought was a really good goal in that opening game.
Yeah.
There's now got its own back, really, for Altinordu.
He's deserved it. Destan's been absolutely on top form in the opening 12 minutes, and that goal just caps off that performance. Well, he's timed his run to perfection, hasn't he?
I wonder what the assistant referee thinks on this near side, who put a flag up.
Why
now, normally there'd be no VAR, the goal would be disallowed.
We'd be sitting here
dissecting it, going, well, that's a goal.
And, you know, I mean, you're taking away a wonderful goal, a cool finish there by Destan. But why is it going on so far? It's like the ball's in the back of the net and then they blow for offside.
Surely, another great ball over the top.
Surely when he has a touch, you give the offside straight away, don't you?
Well, you're supposed to. We saw one in the Real Madrid game earlier on. And we were looking at the linesman who didn't put the flag up until the ball had come off the goalkeeper and gone behind for a goal for a corner.
And it's been a feature
very strange.
It's been a feature of this tournament. I think it might have changed then, the rule.
Very strange. We need to look it up. We'll do that.
Or ask somebody, ask them.
I don't think they'll tell you. They're not very forthcoming with information, to be honest.
No.
Especially where we're concerned. You know, I often wish that referees would come out after games and just give their reasons for certain decisions. And at the end of the day, you have to appreciate referees are human. And this is why VAR has been brought into a system.
Yeah.
And if they come in and say, sometimes they might come in and say, look, OK, I made a mistake. But then, of course, you can't go back and change time. It could cost 3 points in the race for the title.
Like, anyone can say I've made a mistake. We get that and we'd appreciate it. But you know, if it's an honest mistake, and then you go through why you made the mistake and give your honest opinion, we'd appreciate more. I mean, the last couple of nights in the studio, we've had two Qatar managers interviewed. I'll just watch this go on here. Sorry, Matt.
It's Levchenkov. Shitov.
We've just interviewed two Qatar managers that took the time out of their own time, to come into the studio. We asked to do one of the referees or the assistants the other day, and you've got to go through the old shenanigans of getting them into the studio. It's just, let's come in, have a word with us.
Yeah.
We don't want 10 minutes of your time, just to clear up one or two things. I think we'd appreciate it a lot more, wouldn't we?
I think so. We're
not going to grill them all.
Well, We might. It's quite interesting, though, with it being National Sports Day today, the FIFA president, Gianni Infantino, has been here today. Saw a picture of him with the Emir a little bit earlier on. So the FIFA president is here. Thought he might perhaps have popped along just to cast his eye over some of the referees.
If he was anywhere in this vicinity, Nicky Somerville would have grabbed him by the collar, and he would have been doing the half-time interview as well.
I think he's got some sort of radar, some star radar, you know.
What happened the other night? Was it Boudieff, who plays for Casale, was in the far stand, wasn't he? Mid-commentary, he was set off.
He was in a restaurant in Aspire, I think.
And Nicholas Somerville, the roving reporter, was off like a shot.
He was. Now, it's been nice to get people into the studio and just give different perspectives on certain things as well. Yeah. Here's a ball forward towards Zakartsev, away by Kaya.
No one's safe.
Levchenkov, away by Doyeran. Chested off by Gloydman. There's this old Stopyatov.
There's some great supporters in that far stand. It's freezing now, isn't it, Mark?
I'm sat here with a T-shirt on, so I'm not too bad. But certainly, it's one of the smaller crowds that we've had during the tournament. Hopefully, we'll get good crowds for the semi-finals tomorrow.
It's been good this tournament in terms of numbers this year. Certainly, right from the first day, the crowds have come in.
So it has been National Sports Day today, so there's been hundreds of people around this area and Aspire Park just behind us from very early on this morning. Playing football and cricket and lots of different sports and activities going on. It really is a wonderful initiative every year.
Have you done your steps today?
I've done about 11,000.
National Sport Day?
11,000 today.
I thought you'd do more on National Sport Day then. I think your record's 13 and a half.
Left it a bit late this morning. I was going to do two laps this morning just to get in the swing of it.
Yeah. It was too busy, wasn't it? You couldn't make your way around the pass.
Couldn't get around. Well, nice to see all ages coming out as well.
Yeah. Do you have that? I know you do a lot of work in the Indian Super League. Do they have anything like that in India?
Not
in
really.
Sports
probably.
Day? No,
they should have more. I mean, when you consider the amount of people that are in the country, you know, it must be a fantastic untapped resource. Which I think, you know, the Hero Indian Super League has really seen the emergence of Indian players. Yeah. And they climbed to, what was it, 97 in the rankings, their highest ever position. They've dropped back outside the top 100 now. But again, you know, they've big dreams in the future.
Yeah, they had a great start in the Asian Cup. They won the first game, was it 4-1?
Yeah, beat Thailand, but couldn't back it up against the UAE, who were a big side. But the Bahrain game was the killer game as far as India were concerned. A last-minute penalty costing them a place in the knockout stages. And ultimately cost the coach as well, who resigned after the tournament, Stephen Constantine.
Oh, right.
So, yeah, looking for a new coach now. Got the AFC Under-23 Championships coming up as well, which they've just named a provisional squad for. So that's a big one in terms of development for the younger players.
Looking dangerous tonight, Altinordu, and Destan's more or less playing up front on his own, but he's getting plenty of support and he's making those runs and he's getting the ball slid in behind. Spartak Moscow, as I said before, yet to get going.
The most successful club in Russia, Spartak Moscow, 10 Russian championships. Founded back in 1922.
There we go, that's better.
Defending. Shitov going forward again, Dyl. With the clearance. Good cross. Good punch by Yildiz. Oh! Goalkeeper got a save on it as well. A Gunny hacks the ball clear. Spartak keeping the pressure on.
I thought he made a good contact, the goalkeeper, then, but he didn't punch it as far as the 40. First hat, and that was a fabulous chance for Spartak Moscow.
Oh. The referee's pulled it back for the foul.
Well, Here's the chance.
Great punch by the goalkeeper, but managed to redeem himself safely with his leg as well. Vlad Shitov. Levchenkov on the chase. A yellow card for the Spartak number 13, so into the book.
It's the opposite to what I was saying about Altinordi before, where they're not really involved in high-scoring games. Spartak Moscow scored conceded three against Real, scored three against Suwon, then conceded three against Roma. 1-0 down here. So it's either going to stay 1-0 or they're going to get beat 3-0 or win 4-3.
Here's another look at that chance a moment ago. Goalkeeper did really well to get back because he was well out of position.
Good reaction.
Saved it with his legs. Mentioned earlier on in the tournament that the Spartak Stadium, which was used in the World Cup, it's one of the only stadiums I think I've been to where there's a bronze statue behind the goal of the four Starasin brothers who were the founder members of Spartak Moscow. Great deal of history attached already. Yeah. So sort of a long bench with the four brothers, two of them standing, two of them sitting on the bench, made out of bronze. It's a fantastic statue. Well-read by Taguia. Had that chance early on where he put the ball over the bar from close range, but no problems, back on defensive duty.
Normally have a host of Galatasaray shirts in that far stand, don't we? Watching Altinordi.
Destan. Away by Gloydman. Funny enough, I saw them here for the first match earlier on, so maybe they got their timings wrong. Not too many around at the moment, though. Seems familiar. Yellow and red stripes. Corner to Altinordi, who lead by a goal to nil. It's halfway through the first half. It's another one which finds a blue shirt in the area, possibly Kaya with the header that time.
Yeah, well, never came to him, mate. He saw it late, didn't he? Went over most of heads there. Couldn't react to do. Late sighting of the ball.
Second place in the Russian Youth League at the moment, Spartak. Another foul and another yellow card.
Thought he was going to go the other way. See.
It's Rabadanov that's gone into the book. Oh, yeah, it's just gone over the top.
Has he? Oh, whoa. Very naughty.
Yeah, well spotted by the referee. So, second yellow card of the first half.
Yeah, that could have easily broken his ankle. Mm.
So to earlier on, it was unusual, the quarterfinals, all the losing sides, the four losing sides, all failed to score in the quarterfinals.
Mm.
It's unusual fact.
You'd expect a lot more closer games, wouldn't you, at that stage?
Yeah, it's certainly interesting.
I think the closest quarterfinals involved Altinordi against the Spire Academy.
Yeah.
It was a real battle.
Yeah, the goal came early, didn't it? Altinordi gave a real good
second
go.
Second half.
I'd like to have seen him with Destan because I think he could have been the difference in that game for them.
I'd like to have seen him with 24 hours more rest.
Yeah. You notice your top five goals included just one from the quarterfinals, the Nathan Youngcombe's second, where he chipped it over the keeper.
And there were seven goals in that game, and we had quite a fair number of goals in the quarterfinal stage. But
another yellow card one. for Aaron Akgunni. Yeah.
Only that one made it through, really.
Yeah. Again, we said earlier on, you know, we had a couple of free kicks for Real Madrid outside the box. We've not seen any stunning free kicks in this competition as yet, but plenty of time.
Some big, big games tomorrow. Fabulous day ahead of us.
Well, still another six games to come, of course. Semi-finals tomorrow. Rangers, Kashiwa Reysol and Aspire Academy against AS Roma. And on Thursday, it'll be the two winners of today's matches, the two losers playing each other for 5th and 6th, 7th and 8th. And then the third place playoff and the final on Friday evening. Safulin. Rabadanov. Gloydman.
Yeah, it'll be a different atmosphere come Friday night for the final, won't it, Matt, where this is stands apart.
Yep.
The VIPs are here.
Chagla, he's in on goal. He's got Desta with him. He was unselfish. Gloydman.
Oh, clip
the ball away. Plays it back to Akgunni. And he can't get the shot on target. What a chance for Altinordi to go 2-0 up.
Destan's just waiting for that ball to be slid along the ground to him. Once again, Altinordi breaking through this Spartak Moscow defence. Look at Destan's movement. Just slide it into me. I thought he was going to clip it up back to Destan, but he pulls it back and the shot just goes wide. Spartak Moscow's defence is a little bit ropey tonight.
Vaskovic via Czeslav there, just with a few words for his players.
Wow.
On by Destan, lovely ball, Doyeran. Important interception by Gloydman.
There's some great football being produced by Altinordi tonight. Really impressive. Real Madrid were dominant in the earlier game and Altinordi are in this one.
Yeah, their slogan, good person, good citizen, good player, which resonates throughout the club. Tug back on Rabadanov. Might be fortunate to escape without a yellow card here, Uzun. He has escaped without a yellow card. Levchenkov over the free kick. Sepulov. Zakartsev. Good ball in. Goalkeeper got just enough on it to take it away from Vitaly Shitov. Levchenkov. Saumov. Rabadanov. And a few fouls in this first half.
Some fouls to give away there. He's out wide, he's going nowhere. Just hold him up. Don't give him any encouragement to Spartak Moscow. Look at the coach there. Show him away from goals. Stay on your feet. Now Spartak Moscow have the chance to put a free cross into the box.
Yeah, Rabadanov, who was booked earlier on with the free kick. Oh. Goes through everybody, took a deflection, goes for the corner. Goalkeeper was nowhere. Yep. And that agonisingly bounces wide for Spartak.
Yeah, from right here, they get bodies across the eye line of the goalkeeper. He's stranded. So unlucky Creates a goal past the far post there, Spartak Moscow.
Rabadanov. Well, brought down on the edge of the box, and this is a chance for Spartak. It's a clumsy challenge from Tagir. There's the one a moment ago that passed all the way across.
How does that stay out?
We said all along about the importance of those in-swinging deliveries. How often do you see those bounce straight in? There's the foul. And Rabadanov. Rabadanov and Levchenkov poised over the ball.
Well, you said we haven't had a good free kick, is it? There's the time now to step up and give us one.
Safulin on the end of the wall. He'll just try and ease the end player out the way to make a bit of space. Referee will be keeping a close eye. Everybody back behind the ball. Boryskin, the Spartak goalkeeper's in the centre circle in the Altınordu half of the field. And Rabadanov straight into the wall. Cleared away as far as Tolstopyatov. Zakartsev. Almost threaded through to Safulin. This stands offside, so he won't make a challenge for it. Lovely ball across. Here's a chance. Oh, flashes across the face of goal from Chagla.
Great touch by Chagla. Great ball and vision from Destan. Here's the free kick earlier. There we go. The first touch sets him up for the shot. Just drags it wide.
Long ball from Levchenkov. Zakartsev on the chase. Well defended to Gear. Doyeran. Uzun. Celtic. Gives the ball away to Vlad Shitov. This is his brother Vitali. They've won the corner. Referee just wants Sugucak back a little bit further. Another chance for Spartak, enjoying a good spell of pressure at the moment. Came off Chagla. At Gunning. A free kick.
From Altınordu again in the build-up. Really are in the mood. They're passing it quick tonight and the movement's good. Seems to have that understanding.
Sugucak. Celtic.
This is great.
Sugucak. Just tried to go around Samov.
He's just eased out of play there, wasn't he?
I thought the referee might have thought about bringing that back for the foul on Celtic. Certainly seemed to be taken out as he played that ball back to Sugucak. Sugucak. Celtic. Touch was a little bit short. Vitali Shitov. Given away again, though, at Gunning. Destan. Levchenkov. Destan wins it back again. Nice and reverse ball into Celtic. He's all on his own. Waiting for some support. Went for the curler. Pushed away by Boryskin. Davidov will tidy up, but gives the ball away to Doyeran. Destan's gone down injured. And the ball goes out of play and he'll get some treatment, but they won't want to lose Destan in the first half.
Well, there's nothing on for Celtic in the build-up. There we go, he just cuts back on his favourite left foot. Fantastic effort, good save, easy enough save really. Once again, it's Altinordu asking all the questions tonight. There we go, he's just setting off for the far post there, trying to bring it in. Goalkeeper gets a good read on it early on.
He's made a couple of important saves, Boryskin, in this first half. Fortunately for Spartak, nobody following in. Chagla was the closest man to it. They lost their opening game to Real Madrid, but Golyatov's two goals made the Spanish sweat a little bit. 3-1 win over Suwon Samsung. Mataliev, who we touted as being one of the best players in the tournament, but his goal in that one. Golyatov again, and Grigorev with the third. High hanging corner. Header from Kaya. Good shout by Boryskin, though, to gather. By Celtic, one of the smallest men on the pitch, challenging Rabadanov. Good work rate about Altınordu, though, tonight.
Very good performance so far.
Gloydman. Zakartsev. Levchenkov on the chase, but Duryol gets there first. Came off Celtic shins, but he'll still find it. Gunny.
Destan just receiving a bit of treatment down low on the sidelines. Hopefully it'll be okay to carry on.
Yeah, it looks like it's the right arm that's the problem. May just have injured the wrist perhaps as he fell. Safulin. There's going to be another yellow card for Uzun this time. I think the referee just got a notebook out to check that she hadn't already booked the same player then. That yellow card?
No.
Just a mistimed tackle.
It looks really bad, doesn't it, when you watch the replays, but they slow down so much. Mm. And you see, they're all the same fouls, aren't they? It's when someone steps on somebody.
Yes.
So...
Well, Destan's back on. He's gone straight into a defensive role to try and help defend this free kick. He'll be swung in by Rabadanov. Altınordu holding the line just on the edge of the penalty area. Now they'll just drop back. Whipped in with pace. Bodies falling all over the place, and a free kick goes against Spartak.
I mean, once another player steps on the opposition player's toes, you know, they're going down and they seem in a lot of pain. Did you go in the sports shop like it? I asked you to. Did you have a look at these studs? Yeah.
The boots are made of like, aren't they? Paper mache, aren't they, the boots these
they
days?
They are, but underneath the studs, razor sharp, aren't they? Might say that's doing the damage because there's no protection, is there?
No. I don't think anybody had heard of a broken metatarsal until the new style boots came in, had they?
Beckham did it.
Yeah. And then it seemed to be everywhere. Yeah. But they are very flimsy, the football boots these days.
Yeah.
Go back to the days of those Craig Johnston kangaroo skin boots. Yeah. Remember those when he came over from Australia? Have you hopping around all over the place in those?
They were soft leather. That kangaroo skin, gorgeous.
They're very plastic these days, the football boots. Not cheap either. If you've got a son or daughter that wants to be like their favourite star, it's going to set you back a few quid.
I don't want a pair of studs, a pair of moulds. That's two pairs
set away.
Yeah. Yeah. The top boots now, about £200.
Yeah, the proper pro ones, yeah. Celtic almost wins it back off Levchenkov.
That was good pressure out the pitch as well.
Rabadanov. Lovely ball down the line looking for Zakartsev, cut out by Taguia.
He's done well tonight, and he stood out at the back for Alcinordu. Some wonderful defending, and then he brings out defence as well.
Samov. Vitaly Shitov taking a tumble. Good ball. Destan, what a lovely ball that is. He's in behind Gloydman. Destan keepers off his line! What a chance!
We saw that effort in the first game, didn't we, with the volley? That glanced off the top of that crossbar. It's an unlucky crossbar tonight there. What an effort from Destan.
Well, that's one of the best balls. I don't think it was intentional for Destan, but he went for the chip with the goalkeeper off his line, and he's come off the top of the crossbar. What a goal that would have been. That would have been in your top five.
Yeah, definitely. Wonderful effort. Crossbar keeping out Destan, and who was in the early game that had the volley? Let me have a little look. Captani. Captani?
Yeah. Vitaly Shitov. Well, well off target. Nearer the corner flag than it was the goal.
He's looked fabulous, right, Destan. There's his goal. That was a fine finish. Look at the top player, isn't he, this evening?
He's certainly one of the standout performers in the Altınordu team. He has been in all three games. He's scored all three of their goals. Could have had a fourth a moment ago as well. So they missed him against Aspire.
Love it. Quick play again. Quick passing from Altınordu.
Well done, Celtic. Deal. Uzun. Doyuran. At Gunning. Allowed to run by Destan, but through to Boriskin. A couple of minutes to go to half time. That goal from Enis Destan is the separating factor between the two teams at the moment, but they've had chances. Taguia had a good chance. Destan's hit the top of the bar. Boriskin's made a couple of good saves. Celtic looking for Destan. Tolstopiatov just got the ball back to Gloydman. Samov. Shitov.
Oh, yes. Good tackle. Good sound to it as well.
Solid challenge by Uzun.
Oh, that was late.
Well, that Gunny could be in trouble. He was booked earlier on. It'll be a red card. For Atguni.
Referee doesn't realise.
She booked him early on. Well, she's just checking now. She did give him a yellow card earlier on.
You're right,
Mark. He thought he might have got away with that, but Atguni's going to be sent off before half-time. So it's a red card, so another sending off. Doyuran was sent off in the final group game. And now they've had their central midfielder, Eren Atguni, sent off for a heavy challenge. He's claiming his innocence.
What's he doing there?
It's a late challenge. Why dive in when you're on a yellow card?
Yeah, you're
asking for trouble.
You're dominating the match. You're well in control. You've been booked. Why slide in? Why go to ground and take the risk? You know, they're near the halfway line.
Funny enough, I was just literally about to say before that the two central midfielders are both on yellow cards, Uzun and Atguni, and then Atguni goes and does that.
Just before half time as well.
Picked away by Doyuran. He was the man sent off in the game against Bayern Munich. Sent off in the 90th minute as well for a second yellow card. Missed the quarter final. Good ball across. Good header as well by Suguchak. 2 minutes added time at the end of the first half. Altınordu will just want to get through to the break now. Another good footing by Sigurdsson. Rabadanov. Levchenkov, little chip over the top looking for Vladshitov. Gathered though by Yildiz. Well, Spartak will feel they've got a chance now in the second half.
Yeah.
But again, you know, 10 men can often raise the game.
They've been at it tonight, haven't they, Altınordu? So it's still going to be, they're going to be tough to break down in the second half. But I'm sure the coach will just want to get the Spartak players in at half time and tell them how it's going to work out and how they're going to approach this game in the second half.
Tolstopiatov. Plenty of movement up ahead of him. Shitov again is the intended target to Gears header. Zakartsev. Celtic. Nice skills, did well. Found a little bit of space for himself as well. Pursued by Safulin. Doyeran. Chagla. Doyeran. Good pace. Couldn't quite feed it back out to Chagla on that far side. It goes out off Davidov.
Still looking good, aren't they? Even going down to 10 men, Altınordu at the moment.
Chagla. Well, this should enable them to keep possession until half-time. Indeed, it does, as the whistle goes for half-time. It was an eventful first half. Both sides obviously looking to make up for quarter-final defeat. Spartak just 24 hours ago. Altınordu came out in positive fashion. Boryskin made a couple of good saves, but couldn't do anything with Enis Destan's shot, which found the corner. Destan hit the top of the crossbar before Akgunni was sent off at the final part of that first half. So there'll be plenty of work to do for the 10 men in the second half if they're to see their way through to the fifth and sixth place playoff. Spartak will feel the door is open to jar for them. They've got players like Mataliev they could bring off the bench. But Destan has been really head and shoulders above everybody else in that first half. Here is the goal. Lovely touch. Had a look at the goalkeeper and just slipped it into that corner. There's the one that flicked the bar going for the lob over Boryskin. Would have been some goal as it was turning attack into defence, or defence into attack. Half-time stat show. Spartak had more of the ball. 7 shots to 4. And both goalkeepers called into action in that first half. At the break, it's Altınordu 1, Spartak Moscow 0.
نحلق بأحلامنا في سماء الخيال، نمضي نحو المستقبل بكل ثقة في مسيرة من التلاحم. ومتى يحين الوقت؟ ستصبح هذه الأحلام حقيقة، حقيقة تعكس إنجازاتنا طوال السنين، ليولد الحلم ولنفي بوعدنا بتحقيقه.
This is my hero. One of my country's most talented players. Nowadays, talent alone is not enough. Football has changed. There is a place where you can get world-class coaching that pushes you to train harder and harder. Education that helps build your future. Sports science that enhances your performance. And where you are always in the right hands. This place has found me, and I am ready. One day, I want to be his hero.
Aspire Academy. Aspire today. Inspire tomorrow.
Welcome back to our live English language coverage of the Alcat International Cup 2019. It's the playoff matches now today for the fifth and eighth position. They'll play again, of course. At the moment, Altınordu FK are up against Spartak Moscow. Nick Summerby watching the game alongside me here. And I think there's no secret in teams that play the following day after a game find it tough. Altınordu played on Sunday, they get that extra day, there's a bit more zip about them. Spartak Moscow had a very tough match and lost 3-0 to AS Roma yesterday.
Yeah, it was. And plus, for number one, they've been knocked out, and obviously number two, they're playing the next day. So the enthusiasm has just gone a little bit. They're going to try and get something out of it, but Altınordu playing the better in this game, looking more positive. And Spartak Moscow got to somehow they'll try and get something out of the game. It's only 1-0 at the moment, so they're still in the tie.
Led by their captain Destan, who's leading by example.
Yeah, it's a wonderful finish. Lovely tight control. Runs up to the goalkeeper, just waits for the right time and just side foots it past the keeper, and it's a wonderful finish.
There was a question of offside, which it was a late flag. It was a little bit of controversy, but I mean, it's nowhere near offside.
Nowhere near at all. It's all about the finish. No need to be talking about anything like that. It's just about him. VAR, I can tell you straight away by looking at that, it's nowhere near offside. But it's all about him getting his right touch, keeping his composure, you know, just sliding it past the keeper.
But let's thank VAR on this occasion because, listen, we do see some poor offside decisions in the world of football. It doesn't matter where we are. We see it in the QMB Stars League, you know, on a weekly basis. We see it in the English Premier League, some, you know, dodgy decisions. That, I know it was quite clear once we saw it in a replay, and maybe you should say, well, they should spot it anyway. But they had a look, and it wasn't offside, and the goal was given.
But once again, I don't want to be getting too American. You know, all you do is someone tells you near, oh, it's a goal. Don't need to do all that. Get on with the game, we'll carry on. Otherwise, you're going to have a situation where you're stopping and starting. Don't need that. Is it a goal? If it's very close, and it's worth a little bit of a look, you understand that. But I could see that from there wasn't a problem. No, carry on, goal.
Yeah, it's just one play. Yeah.
We don't know. We don't need any of the stuff in between. Just carry on.
OK, let's look closer at that goal then, because it was a lovely goal. I'm glad it stood. I'm pleased the VAR played its part in a positive way. They were so quick to pounce on it, though, weren't they?
Yeah,
they dispossessed them.
Just a little bit sloppy in midfield, Spartak Moscow, but it's about the timing of the run and the timing of the pass. You can see, as I said before, you can see he's well onside. So there's no real thing for VAR, but it's all about the weight of the pass. Once, when you're a centre forward, this is when you come alive. You know, this is where you earn your money. And his first touch just takes him nicely into the box, waiting for the keeper to come out a little bit. Then he can just slide it into that bottom right-hand corner. And You know, that's why if you're very good at doing that, scoring goals, that's why you're worth millions of pounds when you're older. You know, that's where you come alive. That's where you do your business. A lot of people struggle. It's the hardest position on the pitch. But straight away, I thought he was fantastic then when he just waited for him to come out and then just slid it past him.
Other opportunities in this first half. Again, mainly Altinordu.
Yeah, good save by the keeper, fantastic save. Did everything right, tried to just put it, slide it past the keeper. Keeper gets the touch. Once again, wonderful play from midfield. The transition from midfield, obviously going through to the centre forward. It looked like it was a goal, but just gets his fingertips on it and it's a fantastic save.
Not too much for Spartak Moscow, but this wasn't bad.
Yep, it's a nice play. Sharp, crisp passes. Can he get his shot in? Just tries to bend it around the corner, but the keeper's there.
Set piece out. How did that one miss?
It's just come through an area and all of a sudden it's skidded off the floor and bounced up. You know, and all of a sudden it just needed to go into that far corner, but it just couldn't turn enough and it went out. But, you know, that's we talk about free kicks from those sort of angles. You know, you've got to whip it in and get the right pace on it, and it can really cause problems.
Again, Altinordu threatening that Spartak Moscow goal.
He probably just gets a little bit too wide on it with that touch. You know, if he can get the touch in front of him, and then all of a sudden, as he takes the strike, it's always gone away from goal.
Spartak Moscow getting caught out, losing the ball in that midfield area a bit too often.
Yeah, they are, yeah, and all of a sudden. But you have to say as well, then Altinordu, wonderful. And as soon as they get the ball, very positive at pushing forward. This is the right idea. He cuts inside on his strong right foot, tries to bend it for that far corner. It's a very difficult skill that to do it from, especially from that sort of range, but the keeper does it quite easily.
Now,
it's a wonderful.
That would have been. We've seen two opportunities today. One in the previous game, which wasn't a goal, it just skimmed the top of the crossbar. That again, had that one dipped a little bit more, would have certainly ended up in your top five.
Yeah, it probably would have won it. You know, it's a very, very difficult skill. Look at that for a lovely little chip there. Everything's done right. Does it get a touch? Keeper beat, and it just skids off that, off the crossbar. But what a fantastic effort! This is the foul.
Yeah, he was booked earlier. The referee didn't know straight off there.
I mean, that could have been a leg-breaking tackle.
Aghini had been booked.
But he could have been if he actually catches his leg there, that could have really been a leg-breaking tackle. So that is the things what we don't really want in football now. That's what we want the officials to jump on. You know, we don't have any of that at all.
Yeah, no complaints there. Second yellow and then a red card. Aghini, number 25 there, off. Now then, we enjoy the thing is about this tournament, we've seen so many fantastic players performing on these pitches, and they've gone on to play on the very highest level.
The Alcas International Cup. Adrian Rabiot. Back in 2012, Adrian Rabiot, one of the key players in PSG's tournament victory, was already showing his skills. Born in 1995, Rabiot started at the age of 6 in Union Sportive Créteil Lusitanos. At 15, the central midfielder signed with the under-17 PSG team. And only 2 years later, he made his debut in the PSG first team. Since then, he has won 5 French championships, 4 French Cups, 5 Super Cups, and 5 French League Cups. With a market value of 50 million euros, Rabiot is no longer a promise. Without an agreement to renew for next season, it's almost certain that the midfielder will leave the Parc des Princes team. Barcelona are first in line to take him, but until this coming summer, Adrien Rabiot is still playing alongside two of the most expensive players in the world.
Bonjour, c'est Adrien Rabiot. La Alcas Cup, c'était une super expérience. Cette saison, j'espère que le PSG gagnera le tournoi comme on l'a fait nous lors de la première édition. Bonne chance à toutes les équipes, à bientôt.
Well, he's a wonderful player at the Alcas International Cup, and he's turned out to be a wonderful player for PSG. And wherever else he goes, of course, he will make a difference because he's one of the top players.
I would love to be his agent because he's probably the biggest name at the moment out of all the players, and we've had some fantastic players. I've watched him all the time in huge games, in Champions League games, and he's not fazed at all. He really is something special. And I tell you something, watch this space, where he's going to go. It's a host of club. Everybody's queuing up to get him. He's a free agent. Real Madrid, Barcelona, the Premier League, Italy, it's all, wherever you want to go. The world is his oyster where he wants to go now. And he is a something player. Did he stand out in the tournament when he was there? We knew he was a good player, but he never stood out. But he's taken it to a new level.
And one player who may stand out or has already been standing out in this tournament is number 10 there, who's coming on, Mutaliev. Although he was taken care of in the game against Roma. Let's hear more about the changes now and rejoin Chris Makin and Mark Tompkins.
Thanks, Rod. Before we get into the Moscow changes, we tell you Ozan has come off for Altınordu and Tatlı has come on in midfield. It's a triple change for Spartak at the start of the second half. Grigoriev, Mutaliev and Kozadub are all coming on. In fact, it might be more than that. Grigoriev is coming on for Vitali Shitov. It's a quadruple change, it looks like, so lots to do for the fourth official.
Lots to do for you.
Lots to do for me. Seferin's coming off for Kozadub. Mutaliev, who was impressive throughout, was kept quiet yesterday by Tomasini, who had a wonderful performance for AS Roma. So Mutaliev coming on for Zakartsev, and the fourth player to come on will be Krumin. Just wait and see who the last player to come off is. And it's Tolstopyatov, so...
Well, either the coach has decided to give all the players, as many players as possible, 45 minutes each, or he's going for it in this second half.
Pretty good fan banner there in the Spartak Moscow colours. Don't forget Altınordu down to 10 men. We're underway. It's Altınordu in red and blue, kicking from right to left in the second half. Davidov has gone inside alongside Gloitman, with Krumin dropping in at right back. Taliev has gone to his usual left-sided position. Goyeran bursting down the line early on, wins the free kick.
I tell you what, Spartak Moscow players came right out of the traps and trying to put the pressure on the Turkish players, but Altınordu played the way out from the back then. And it's wonderful play from the Turkish side, to get out of that spot above that.
Duyaran was in full flight. Again, he just seemed to land awkwardly on his wrist, but he's okay. Possession handed back to Spartak. Shevin, the Altınordu coach. Side leading by a goal to nil. Enis Destan with the goal. Gunis sending off, though, means they're down to 10 men for the whole of the second half.
Playing right midfield now, Destan. There he is.
Sigurchak looks like he's the most forward player. Tatley's come on in midfield to give them a bit of stability there as well. Played in all three games prior to tonight. With Vlad Shitov. He's got him Levchenkov's way. Destan. This is might be where they're at their most dangerous. Celtic on the chase. Should be easy for Boriskin.
Well,
Kaya, goalkeeper's a long way off his line.
That would have been some effort from the halfway line.
Well, into the breeze as well. hard to believe this is the 20th match of the tournament already. Well cut out by Celtic. Kozadub. Mutaliev. A great job done on him yesterday by Tomasini from AS Roma.
A wonderful play, wasn't it, from Tomasini? He was man of the match for me, just for the role that he played, stopping the most dangerous player from Spartak Moscow.
He got substituted late in the game as well, which was a testament to how well Roma had contained him. So we saw him in that opening game against Real Madrid, and he was teasing the fullback with the runs down this, well, down the near side when they were kicking from right to left. It's kept in by Cromin. Bojaran's header. Just caught Grigoriev there. I don't think there was any malice in it. Just a knock with the arm. Yeah. To offer his apologies, Dojuran. Teams can make up to five changes, so Spartak have one more left. Four more available to Ilkishevin. Badenov went down, there was no free kick given.
I'd love to see that one again, because he flung himself to the ground then.
Davidov. Samov. With Badenov. And through to the goalkeeper. Good turn by Chaglet.
Well done. Great forward play that by Chaglet. Especially with him being down to 10 men, he's going to have to do a lot more of that in this second period, but just holding the ball up there for his team.
It'd be interesting to see the tactics employed by Altonordo in this second half. Now they're down to 10 men.
Well, look at, you know, they're going to go on the counter attack, aren't they? There we go. That man there, Destan with the armband, has dropped into midfield now. Just playing more or less as a lone strike in the first half for Altonordo.
Levchenkov. Nicely done. Good challenge.
What a tackle.
That was Kaya with a challenge and then Tagir with a block. Good defending by Altonordo.
Fantastic tackles, and even more importantly because they're in their own box, so they've got to be timed to perfection. Wonderful tackles there from Altonordo.
Corner taken short. Mataliev's attempted cross is blocked. Goes out for a goal kick. Just quickly looking ahead to tomorrow. Rangers, Kashiwa, Reysol, Aspire, AS Roma. What are you expecting? What are you hoping for tomorrow in those games?
I'm doing the first game with you. So we're doing Rangers, Kashiwa. And that's just an intriguing matchup, isn't it? You can see Rangers, they won't change their game plan. Rangers, they want to dominate possession, get forward as much as possible. Kashiwa, I'm sure they'll just sit in there, won't they, Mark? And hope for the counter-attack. And when they do counter-attack, they're quite deadly, aren't they? Once to look forward to that one, isn't it? To open the day up.
Yep, they showed that yesterday, Kashiwa against Real Madrid. Got the penalty and then a
second
goal,
though. Win it high up the pitch.
Yep.
Get out wide, sharp passing. You've got to be... I think the thing for the Rangers players is the defence got to be clued in all day long. Well, up 90 minutes, which is a hard task. If they're going to dominate possession as much as they like to, then the defensive players have got to be aware of the counter-attack coming from Kashiwa.
Talk about the other game in a second. Here's Dojuran. Chagla. Celtic.
Ooh. Still getting forward, aren't they? Altonordo. Good play down this left-hand side.
Good ball in. Couldn't quite get over the volley. Celtic. Yeah, the other game, Aspire Academy looking to reach the final for the second time in 2 years. And certainly had the bit between their teeth against Altınordu, but it's only 1-0. They had to work hard to get their goal intact. To say if Destan would have been playing for Altınordu, it might have given them a slightly different dimension. Has a great-looking ball in. Kaya with an important touch with Rabadanov just behind him.
What a ball coming in from Crummy. Well off target with the earlier ball there, whipped in from Crummy down this right-hand side. Real teaser of a cross.
There's the shot that went wide, but Crummy, who came on at half-time, been ever present in the other three games, like Kosadub and Grigoriev and Bataliev for that matter. All four of the substitutes had started all three of the previous games.
Well, the crowd's dropped down for once, Matt. We've got a few hardy souls over there still braving this this cold weather. Amazing, isn't it? You know, obviously the crowd's not a big, but there we go.
Rabadanov.
Not a bad effort. Good play from Spartak Moscow. People still love football, don't they? Yeah. He's still coming in. There's a guy there stood at the top of the stand. He's got his shorts on.
Hardy soul.
Just love football, don't they, these people?
Yeah, it's been good to see good crowds this year. A lot of younger children, school children, coming out for the earlier games, early in the competition as well. This is Mataliev. Blocked away.
When he's on form and when he's on song, he seems to just ghost past players, seems to drift past them. Lovely movement.
To Spartak corner. Curled in by Mataliev. Oh, it's come off Destan, be another corner. Those in-swingers will just have the wind behind them as well, which will help float them in towards the goalkeeper.
Tell you what, there's another good player just about to come on for Altınordu, Kvrazli.
Yeah, he and Destan have combined very well in the earlier games. Kvrazli set up the goal for Destan in the Bayern Munich match. Great. Yeah. Wide play. Chagla's the man coming off. So Kvrazli again, who'd started all three of Altınordu's previous games, comes on. Straight into defensive mode though. Kosadub. Here is Kvrazli. He's had his way blocked by Crummin. Oh. Look, a foul throw from Kosadub. Got away with it. Bloydman. Samov. Mataliev. Levchenkov. Davidov. Kosadov force crossfield. Samov. Man who had that shot wide a moment or so ago. Here is again Samov. That's a heavy touch. Kaya did just enough. I think that might have gone out for a goal kick. No, it didn't cross the line.
Yeah, Kayan and, sorry, Matt. Yeah, Kayan and Tagir, they're doing really well, aren't they, in the sense of defence, making some timely interceptions and tackles.
Again, it goes out off Crummin. Vashkovic via Czeslav. He's made his four changes. hoping his side can break down Altınordu as this half wears on, down to 10 men.
You think about making all the changes, he's brought some of the bigger names on, and you think he's going to be an improvement in performance, but he still played only yesterday, didn't they? So there's still going to be tired legs out there in Spartak Moscow.
It's quite lonely, that Altınordu fan, just standing there on the steps. Ball over the top from Destan. Celtic will borrow skin under pressure, but the goalkeeper will get there first. Tagir's header, only as far as Grigorov. Destan. Kvrazli. Destan, that'll just beat him into touch. Wasn't a great ball back to him by Kvrazli. A clumsily given away by Samov over on the far side as well, so Altınordu will take that all evening.
Fairly comfortable for Altınordu since he started the second half. Out of 10 men have that goal to hang on to. They are doing that at the moment.
Italia with a quickly taken throw to Rabadanov. Away by Kaya. Kvrazli trying to turn. Kromin stuck tightly to him. Given away again to Doyeran. Kromin just tucking inside, keeping an eye on Kvrazli, which might play into Doyeran's hands. Now he comes across. Kvrazli just allowed it to roll across his body.
Oh,
Celtic. Plucked out of the air by Boriskin, who thought he was shaping up for a Kvrazli shot there on the edge of the box.
It was. He worked it really well, didn't he, Altınordu? He's still defending ever so well, aren't they?
Challenge again by Kaya. Half-time substitutes have definitely made a bit of a difference to Spartak. Kromin and Kozadub down this near side. Mataliev over on the far side.
Kromin's done well.
Yeah. Grigorov as well. It's a whole new right side, really, for the Russians in the second half. Levchenkov. To make a final drop, Boriskin just charged down by Celtic. Could have gone anywhere. Fortunately for the goalkeeper, it just ricocheted inside his area.
Well done, Celtic, and maybe you can say he deserved the goal from that.
Looks like Spartak are going to bring on Golyatov. Three goals to his name already. Oh, lovely ball. Mataliev, it's a great chance. Oh, it's another brilliant challenge from Tagir, or was it Kaya? It was Kaya with the challenge.
Offside.
It was a slip by the goalkeeper at the other end when he was charged down by Celtic. Quite relieved just to see that one drop inside his area.
He's
and then
side.
The offside a moment ago. Just, I think.
Yeah.
Very close. Destan. Saguchak, he's onside, he's got two in the middle. Destan's one of them. That's pulled back too far though. Behind Kvrazli.
It was only just, it was a good idea, wasn't yeah. it?
Samov. Rabadanov.
Oh, well
showed
done.
Too much of it again.
Well done, Kaya. He's been excellent in the second half so far.
Kozadub. Levchenkov. Kaya there again with the header. Destan Kvrasny wanted it played into his path. That's not a great ball.
Just got to go a little bit wider.
Just so it rolled, didn't he? Rolled into his path. Levchenkov. It's a fairly open game. Now we are going to see the final Spartak substitution. It's going to be Gloydman that's coming off, the central defender, and Golyatov coming on. Golyatov wore the captain's armband for the first three games as well. Scored twice against Real Madrid and got the second against Suwon Samsung. Levchenkov. Looks like Levchenkov has dropped into the back four.
They've got to step up here, haven't they, Spartak Moscow? Only 11 men against 10. Not really cutting open Altinado.
Goyeran. Stepped away again by Kaya. Levchenkov. Golyatov. Kozadub. Great ball in. Mutaliev. Handball. Awkward one as it came over a crowd of players for him to see, but he's claiming it wasn't handball. Have another look.
I thought it was ideal with him being right-footed in the angle that he came in, maybe taking the volley on first time.
Bounced off it onto his arm. Can't really legislate for that. It's a bit of an awkward one. Kozadub.
Still defending well, aren't they, Altinado? Still getting about the pitch, even though they're down to 10 men. Here we go.
Good ball over the top. Celtic. Levchenkov comes across. Still going, Celtic. He's all on his own. Kvrasny. Doyeran, oh, down the line, but out of play. Good chance for Celtic. Good covering, though, by Levchenkov. When you think, as you say, they're playing with 10 men, but they've still got the same number of defenders because they've dropped a man back. So there's not that much space in defence. It's sort of more middle of the park where
they're not sat back, and they're still getting forward, aren't they?
But they're defending when they need to defend, which I think that's why they brought Tatley on in the second half, just to get some fresh legs in there. They drop Destan back into a more midfield role. Kaya, oh, he's played well. Here he goes.
Go on.
Good pace from the big central.
Wow.
Defender.
No one can get off with him.
Celtic arriving on the edge of the box.
Oh, he's done it.
Nicely pulled back, but Levchenkov gets there to cut the ball out.
You're saying there's no one with him. He was too fast for everyone.
Well played by Doyeran.
This is great play by Altinado. I'm really enjoying this performance, by the way.
Goyeran wins the throw.
Kaya has been absolutely outstanding.
Central defender come winger a moment ago.
He took off then, didn't he? Head down,
there was no stopping him, was there?
No.
Remember the old days, John Terry used to come charging forward through the Chelsea defence.
I remember Gordon McQueen at Old Trafford doing that. But the old tango, tango ball. Gordon used to set off and all the crowd used to go crazy.
Nothing like seeing a central defender go bombing forward, is there? Destan.
He's about 6 foot four, though, Gordon McQueen, no one is.
Yes. A mop of red hair. Samov. Levchenkov. Well read again by Doyeran.
Yeah.
In towards Kozadub.
Been up to 70 minutes and the pace of the game hasn't dropped, and neither has the pace of the Alcinodu players, are still making those interceptions, making the tackles.
Yeah, approaching the midway point of the second half, Alcinodu is still leading by that goal in the first half. Golyatov looks suspiciously offside then.
Yeah, but he won't give it till now, will they?
Oh, no. He's gone for a corner. Right. Here's a bit of defending to do. Just Celtic staying up for Alcinodu. At least they're leaving a player up, which means that there are a couple of defenders staying back for Spartak. Not a great corner, headed away. And then on by Kaya. Doyeran, Celtic. Doyeran's gone on ahead.
Oh, God, Celtic, fabulous play.
Kvrazli, lovely ball with the outside of his foot. Doyeran trying to get inside Vlad Shitov. He's won it back. Offside flag up.
I certainly think it's coming to this point where they let the phase of play go on. It's happening every time, isn't it? It's not when the play, if the player's offside, it's not when he's had the touch that they're giving offside.
Yeah. Golyatov. Nice space. Oh. Good finish. And Spartak have got level. And Alcinodu have been beaten. The substitutes have done well. Mutaliev was involved. Golyatov there, his fourth goal of the tournament. And Spartak have finally got the breakthrough. It's 1-1.
Mutaliev just drifts inside. Look at this with a defence splitting pass. Wonderful play there by Mutaliev. Great finish from Golyatov. Like I say, Mark, four goals this tournament. Has he just gone top goal top scorer? Yep. Mutaliev just drifts inside. He's so dangerous when he does that. What a pass that was. Just for the vision to see Golyatov and then to pick him out with that pass was very good play.
It's tough on Alcinodu, who've defended exceptionally well. Down to 10 men since the first half when Akgunni was sent off. Samov. Davidov. Grigorev, chip over the top once again, looking for the runner for Badanov. Yildiz falls on the ball. If it was level at 90 minutes, we would have penalties. There is Akgunni in the stands. Grigorev. Dished out a bit of treatment to Desta, not for the first time. Injured his arm in the first half. It's his right leg, I think, cramp just creeping in. No yellow card, though, for Grigorev. Golyatov, the man who got that equalising goal. Lovely ball.
Good touch as well, wasn't it? Perfect first touch.
Just got it out of his feet to get the angle for the shot. Here's a change for Alcinodu. Oztürk coming on. Sagucek is the player that's gone off. Third change for the Turks. Deal. Was out of Samov. Little band of Turkish supporters over on that far side. Oztürk. Deal. Is out of play.
There's a guy in the far stand there, he's been stuck with that placard, or is it a flag? Or he's been there all game, it's absolutely freezing. Is he on his own?
I think he's on his own. There's one at one end and there's an Alcinodu fan at the other end.
Left. Yeah.
I think he'll probably win the fan banner competition. Decent prizes, I think.
Gotta be in it to win it.
A few,
and he's
a few reals richer by the time he goes home. I have to say, some of the banners have an awful lot of work put into them.
Yeah.
Kvrazlik just keeps the ball in play.
Love it.
Teasing Krumin.
Still going.
Just lost his footing, but he's still going.
Go on.
Still going, Kvrazli! Goodness me, that would have been some goal had he gone in. Great persistence by Kvrazli on the edge of the area. And he almost comes up with a finish.
Yeah. Just wanted that goal to go in there, sorry, that shot to go in. That would have been some goal.
Brilliant play. Don't rule Altonorde out of this. They might be down to 10, but they're still creating chances. Spartak have got the big guns on, though. Mataliev, Golyatov, Kozadub, Grigorev. Away by Boryskin. Good ball, Samov. Grigorev. Almost finds its way to Golyatov, away by Tagli. Celtic. Well, went back by Grigorev. Can't find Mataliev though. Well read by Duryol. Both sides giving possession up cheaply at the moment. Oztürk.
Still a little bit slack with the passing, aren't they? Spartak Moscow.
Samov. Davidov. Giving away Oztürk.
Oh, right across the face of goal.
Oh, needed to get that across because Kvrazli was all on his own. And it's gone for a corner.
Still looking dangerous, Altonorde. Like you said, Matt, you can't write them off. Very even game.
Celtic's gone across to take the corner. They've got Kaya up for this one. Tagir has stayed back because they've left Golyatov up. It's into the near post, headed away by Rabadanov. Duryol. Back by Destan. Kaya. Duryol.
Oh!
Destan. On the turn! Good save, Boryskin. Cleared away by Levchenkov. Great chance again for Altonorde.
Great build-up play as well by Altonorde. Doing everything right so far.
Lovely ball from Destan. Kvrazli. Blocked by Krumin. Good game, this.
It was a good chance out for Destan, and you just feel he was at the right height for the goalkeeper along the ground. I'm expecting it to hit the back of the net.
Oztürk. Duryuran. I have to say that these games sometimes can be a little bit of a letdown at this stage when they're losing the quarterfinals, but both games today have had something a little bit about them. This one particularly. Altonorde getting into a bit of bother at the back. Tagir away again. Kozadub. He's putting Levchenkov under a bit of pressure. Oztürk will close him down. Samov. Just keeps the ball in play.
I think he could control that with his face.
Lovely ball threaded through, looking for Vladshitov. Good defending again by Tagir. Oztürk.
Turn.
Samov was a little bit tight to him, allowed him to turn away. Destan. Celtic.
Come on, get up there.
Kvrazli's coming on this near side. Celtic might not need him. Well played, Krumin.
He's a strong defender, Krumin.
Here he is again.
Oh.
Mataliev.
Oh.
Just took his eye off the ball.
What a ball by Krumin as well. Drove it out wide. There's that chance. Let's have a look. A good tight for the goalkeeper.
Good touch from Destan. It just dropped the ball in front of him. Enabled him to get that shot in.
Difference was Golyatov at the other end. His first touch was great, but he just drove his shot right along the ground. It's harder for the goalkeeper.
Anticipation on the bench and in the stands.
We thought it was in, didn't we?
Yeah. Rabadanov. Kozadub. Nice little drop of the shoulder. Still going here. Kozadub. Good hands, Yildiz. Maybe to be sure with that one.
In the the Russian bench trying to get the players going.
Grigoriev almost found Golyatov, caught in possession. Ozturk away from Samov. Well, Samov's recovered well. Vladshitov. Rabadanov. Vladshitov with a shot, but well, wide of the target.
Yeah, keep it wide, go wide then. Get the move going. Good position.
Good hands by the goalkeeper. Efe Yildiz. Scratch of the head from Vyacheslav. He's made his changes. Can his side get another goal? Will there be a winner inside the 90 minutes, or will we have our first penalty shootout of this year's edition? The winners of this will play Real Madrid for 5th and 6th. The losers will play Etoile for 7th and 8th. Free kick to Spartak. Levchenkov over the free kick. Kozadub, far too high.
Just letting Nolsonaro go off the hook, really, with those long-range efforts. Just keep the ball, and that's a few seconds, get further up the pitch, closer to goal.
Altonordo about to make another change. It's Metin, who wore the captain's armband in their games, who's been impressive, the fullback. Doyeran. Nicely done again, Grigoriev. Dyol. Ozturk up ahead of him. Going on a forward run, Dyol. Tracked by Samov. Ozturk. Dyol. Celtic in the centre. Need to get Destan in there, he's the aerial presence. And they've been caught on the edge of the penalty area.
Poor play from Spartak again, though. Just some sloppy passes coming into their general play last few minutes.
See whether it's a straight swap, Metin for Dyol. It's a foul on Celtic. A chance to whip a free kick in here. Levchenkov just dangled out a leg and look, Celtic. Over the free kick. Once again, Kaya's gone forward, Tagir staying back. Destan just been spoken to, along with Davidov. Again, it's that angle where if the ball comes in with a bit of pace, they are making a change. It's Celtic that's going off just as he was about to take the free kick, which is quite a strange decision.
Is it Chelton going off who's about to take it? He's going to take the free kick. He's going to leave it now.
Yeah, he's gone off the other side of the field, Celtic. But he placed the ball, got it already for the in-swinger. Now it's going to be an out-swinger from Tatley. Metin's on. Celtic disappointed. Needs a good delivery. Kaya! Get enough on it. Goal kick. Okay. by Destan. Go out for another throw to Spartak in the corner. Destan. The shins of Samov. Here comes Spartak. Mutaliev. Weaving his way through. He's done well, Mutaliev. Gives away the free kick. He thought it should have gone the other way, but it was a foul on Kaya. Yeah, just clipped his leg.
His free kicks going forward. He's still got three up front there. Altinordu still looking to win the match.
To gear. Tatley.
Great Metin. Skill.
Metin
great.
Looks like he's gone to a central midfield role.
Great skill by Kaya.
Here is Metin. Crumbing tight to him though. Davidov. Levchenkov back to Boryskin. Where's our winner coming from, if there is to be one?
Penalty spot.
6 minutes away from a potential penalty shootout. Mutaliev, just in behind Golyatov. Destan, just showed too much of it to Mutaliev. Now Rabedanov. Three in the middle. Mutaliev on the overlap.
Oh,
good challenge, Kaya.
Oh, that's
some tackle.
That sums up his game and his evening today, Kaya. Wonderful. We know what Mutaliev was like in that position. He's going to give it the old swivel hips, but you read it, Kaya. Wonderful tackle in his own area as well. He's been outstanding today. Same sort of performance as that Tomasini yesterday for AS Roma, defending the. Defending outstanding today.
Destan's gone down.
He doesn't mind a little moan, does he, old Destan? He likes going down and he's a big lad.
So a free kick to Altidordu into the final 5 minutes. That yeah, flailing
not,
arm
just caught him.
Kaya with the free kick. Levchenkov. Shitov. Kvrazli. Good solid challenge from Shitov. Tatley just trying to weave a way through. Now, Mutaliev. Kaya gives chase once again. Well, he's gone a little bit early this time. Back to his feet quickly. And still gets a tackle into concede the corner.
Kaya's doing a Tomasini. And Mutaliev.
Everybody coming back for Altinordu. Won't want to concede a goal now. It's Mutaliev with a corner. Away by Destan. And then by Metin. Another corner. Kozadov to come across and take this one. Destan's led his side well. Had a Gunny sent off, don't forget, in the first half. Just across the forehead of Davidov. Mutaliev. Away by Kaya. Grigorev into the box. Away again by Kaya. Krumin's header. Good jump by Destan. All bobbling around. Metin on the chase, Crumbing back to the goalkeeper. Metin will keep going. Coolly done by Boryskin.
Not want to concede a late goal here, will he? Altinordu, they've worked ever so hard to get to this many of attacks as well during the second period, but they worked so hard to get to this stage of the match where they can take it to a penalty shootout. Down to 10 men for the second half, haven't they?
They've done well. Mataliev.
There he is. Oh, just scuffs his shot. Oh, hard luck. Wonderful build-up play there by Altinodu again. Been so impressed with him in this second half.
Spartak throw. Rebedinov. Grigoriev. Mataliev. Still can't find that little bit of quality, but he does win a corner off Dyrjol. Just doing up his boot. Referee just pointing to the watch to say she'll allow for that in the stoppage time. Good play. Saumov comes across and makes an important challenge. Mataliev. Just run away from him a little. Good ball across. Oh! Golyatov! It's harsh on Altinordu, but the substitute has got his second goal of the game, his fifth of the tournament. And it's the big guns that have come off the bench that look like they've won this one for Spartak Moscow. Ilya Golyatov with the finish. And Altinordu's brave resistance is broken. It squirmed away from Yildiz. Cross may have taken a slight deflection. And Golyatov just toe-poked it in from close range. There's a player down. I think it's Kaya that stayed down for Altinordu. But that is so, so harsh. Having taken the lead through Enis Destan in the first half, had a gunny sent off. They didn't sit back, they kept pressing forward. But it looks as though, unless there's a miracle in the 3 minutes of added time, they'll be playing for seventh and eighth place on Thursday. Slight irony is the fact that the two matches that will take place as it stands on Thursday, the two matches which started the groups off, Etoile against Altinordu for 7th and 8th, and Spartak against Real Madrid for 5th and 6th. Altinordu, I'm sure we'll just go for this now. Might as well lose 3-1 then. Not go for it at 2-1. Oztek. Well, leaving a few gaps now. Spartak might exploit them. Kozadub. Poor touch. Metin. Caught by Kozadub. Be a free kick, which they'll take quickly. Destan. Oztürk. Destan's continued his run too close to Boryskin. It was outside the box, though. Had to keep his cool then, the goalkeeper. Tatley. Have to say, for a playoff match, it's been a very, very good game of football. Oztürk can't get the ball across and will run it out of play for a throw in the corner. Coming up to 2 minutes added time. There will be a little bit more than the 3 minutes added time, I think, for the injury to Kaya. Metin Kozidub wins it back. Good challenge by Tatlik. Is there one last chance here for Altınordu? Oh, he's given the free kick away. Free kick to Spartak. Surely they'll just run the ball now into the Altınordu half of the field. Kaya just caught. Surely they'll just launch this one. Grigoriev stands on the ball to prevent the quick free kick. Kaya goes over the ball, Tagir's in there. They're going to leave it for Tatli to launch in. Kaya's going in as well. This is the last chance, surely, now for Altınordu to grab an equaliser. Oh, it's not a great free kick. Sliced out. Disappointing. Well, Ilka Shevin can be proud of the way that his team have performed. Down to 10 men for more than half the game. Took the lead through Enis Destan, but Bolyatov adding to his stock with a couple of goals. Krumin lobs the ball over the top. Dürjol, as the full-time whistle goes, and Altınordu will play for 7th and 8th place, having lost here in the playoff. It was a late, late goal from Golyatov that won it for Spartak Moscow. They'll